any Olympic host country wants to show off. In the case of South Korea, Seoul is perhaps the perfect showcase. This thoroughly modern capital city is in a region that's home to more than 25 million people, half the country's population. There is Wi-Fi on the subway, shimmery architecture, and some remnants of the past, like the changing of the guard at the Royal Palace, built in 1395. People still cram into a market for a quick meal. On the menu, rolled seaweed, dense rice chunks and red chili sauce, pork, and Korean blood sausage. But the Winter Olympics are not here in this pulsing city. They're happening a couple hours to the east of Seoul, in a mountainous region called Pyeongchang. With the Olympics here, there are more visitors, which means more snacks.
천혜의 자원을 기반으로 해서 봄, 여름, 가을, 겨울 사계절 내내 많은 관광객들이 오고 있는데요. 동계올림픽 같은 것들을 위해서 교통이 발전되고 숙박시설이 늘어나고 이런 거에 대해서는 긍정적으로 생각하고 지역 주민들 또한 긍정적으로 생각하고 원하던 일이었습니다.
Some 6,500 athletes and coaches and 100,000 visitors a day are showing up in alpine-like resorts and small towns. And they all have to eat. The specialty here is buckwheat.
메밀이 되게 인기가 많죠. 깔끔하고 담백하니까.
There are buckwheat crepes filled with vegetables and kimchi, cold noodles topped by raw beef, even buckwheat sprout juice made with yogurt.
저희 같은 경우는 올림픽도 진짜 중요한 숙제라고 생각하는데 그보다 더 중요한 숙제는 평창이라든가 봉평 외국 분들이 왔다 가시고 그 올림픽보다 더 중요한 거는 사람, 음식, 긴가민 그런 게 더 중요하다고 생각해요.
If not buckwheat, this region is also known for its small plates. Many small plates of root vegetables.
간이 싱겁고 네, 뭐 짜지 않게 그런 부분 좋아하시고요.
There is bonnet bellflower root, grilled dried pollock, and acorn jelly.
많이 인기가 있을 것 같아요. 맵지 않고 짜지 않고 해서 외국 분들이 좋아하실 것 같아요.
An Olympic-sized spread of simple rustic food, the food of the Korean countryside, something not changing for these games, while everything else seemingly is.